my ghosts. On this episode, we talk about it. Every homie ain't your homie. Every brother ain't your brother. Every sister ain't your sister. It's just a sad fact of any type of circle that's created. And we get into it on this episode of Demons Row TV. And oh yeah, we ghosting, baby. My ghosts, welcome to Demons Row TV, the holy grail of MC culture, where we cover everything motorcycle club involved. I'm Sos the Ghost, I'm your host for the evening, and today we're going to talk about it. The sad truth, the fact that you can't gather a certain group of people without it getting splintered and certain people, you know, getting into their factions and their little cliques. It's the worst part of any type of organization, and this goes on across the table. It's not just MCs, gangs, anything, work, you know what I mean? Anybody can relate to the cliquey shit that all of us hate so much, but so many people take part in, and we gotta do our part to fix that. And we're gonna get into that, but the first thing I want you to do, like we always do on this channel, is to hit me with that pound ghosting, and that lets me know you're alive and well, sitting on twos, doing what you do, or just part of the Demons Row community, one of my ghosts. Shout to all my new subscribers, welcome to the row. Shout to everybody that's been supporting the Demons Row clothing, so much love and support in this community, much love to y'all for that. Follow the Sos the Ghost page. I got my EP done. I'm going to be releasing on there. A lot coming soon. All right, we're going to set it off like this. The certified ghosted of the week goes to Lydia Reyes from California. She is repping the Old School Riders MC. She has at Bikers Chicks Inc. The bike that she rides, she got the 2016 Softail Slim. I got the 17, so it's Softail Gang over here. Her bike is super crazy. And if you see her Instagram, follow her on Instagram. She ride for real. Like, if you see her, she's controlling the roads. So check her out on Instagram. Much love, Lydia. You are my certified ghosted of the week. This week's certified ghost goes out to Cali. Once again, Cali's getting a lot of love on Demons Row TV. Big shout to Los Angeles Deftone. This brother on Instagram, his Instagram is Los Angeles Deftone. This brother's photography is amazing. So I started doing photography a little over 2 years ago and tried some different types, but I felt I needed to capture the MC culture. I pretty much concentrated on that for 2 years now, more specifically the Mongols MC. My work displays the brotherhood of an often misunderstood culture. With little experience as a photographer and always being careful not to be influenced by trends, I choose to pay attention to my instincts. I use my photography to erase stereotypes and defy the notion created by mainstream media that my subjects, friends rather, are criminals or a biker gang. So big shout to you, Los Angeles Deftone. You are definitely certified ghost. Now, if you know anybody that's certified ghosted or certified ghost material, hit me on Instagram at DemonsRow, at SosTheGhost _, and let me know. Tag me. I put up a post constantly, you know, repping. And I did this because I want to continue to show love to the community that showed me so much love. But let's get into it. Every homie ain't your homie. Every brother ain't your brother. Now, this is lessons that a lot of us have learned in the most fucked up of ways. You know what I'm saying? Like, it sucks and it shouldn't be like this. Like, if somebody's wearing the same cut as you, they should have that pride in it, where anybody with that cut is a brother to them. But sadly, even in your own chapter or in your own state, you will have brothers that fraction off into their own little cliques. And you know, this goes on in the workplace, anywhere. You know what I mean? In gangs, it happens everywhere. People, I don't know what the mindset is, where you expand and you get a lot of numbers and it's a great feeling. And it always starts like that. You start a little small, you expand a little, you feel so good, and then before you know it, it's a couple of hundred or 50, you know, whatever your club may be or your situation may be. And you just expand and it feels so good, and you have that like fun period where you're so bonded with them and everybody's riding out. And then time goes by and then people start fractioning off. I could never understand the reason why people don't understand that we're so much stronger together than divided. In life in general, you have your times where money isn't as good. You may be going through whatever at the time. Some clubs are very expensive with dues, so sometimes brothers will get behind. I've seen situations where other brothers are looking down on that brother because of dues. Now, first off, if you're looking down on your brother because of financials, that's not brotherhood. That's not what this is about. And if you're in a position to have money to talk down on somebody and you call them your brother, why aren't you putting the bread up for them? You know what I'm saying? This mentality is what makes teams very weak. Brothers will sit at that table and get chastised for not having a certain amount of money to pay for a dues or for whatever it may be, a fine, whatever it is. And I've seen a brother take money, throw it as a donation, oh here, and that could have fully covered the brother's dues. But instead, you want to chastise the brother and then use the money for other purposes. Like, that is not what brotherhood is about. Like, I know brothers that have been wearing their cut, go down, and are paraplegic, and their club doesn't even have contact with them no more. Probably didn't even pick up the cut. Like, I've seen non-brotherhood, and it sucks, man. And it's like, if you're in a situation where you don't have to deal with that at all, you are truly blessed. I've seen that a lot of times, if you really think about all the people that were famous that got killed and their situations, a lot of times with rap music, I know a lot of y'all are like 50-50, a lot don't listen, some listen, but a lot of the rappers, they get killed, it's always somebody in their circle. It's always somebody that knows you well. Your enemies half the time are not the ones that will cross you. It is your so-called friends, so-called brothers. And we need to get to the point of understanding as MCs that we're so far ahead of that, that should be ancient history to us. There's no way that this type of mentality should still be going on in our culture. Our culture needs to evolve from cliques. If somebody, it doesn't matter if somebody's in a nomad chapter or in another state, and you're clicking up with your brothers just because you're in this state. If they're wearing the same cut as you, that's your brother. Don't put the cut on if you don't think that. Because then it's like, you might as well just wear whatever you're repping. Like, if you're just repping you and your little clique, then you need to not be in a club and dishonor that back patch. Just wear your little clique, you know, whatever, your hat or whatever, and leave this culture. We don't need that shit in this culture. That goes on everywhere, and it's not needed here. We're way above that. And you know, just the fighting over, you know, territories and like that. How are we going to get over territories and these type of issues if we can't even clean our own mess? And then you have the ambition, the people with a lot of ambition. And listen, ambition is dope. If you want to be a president, a leader, that's a great quality. But you need to put in your work. You need to not be a snake about it. You don't need to snake your brother or talk down a brother because maybe you're a vice president, or you're on the board, so you're right there, you're close to president, but you have aspirations of being a president. And I know people that like want to be a president, and the president will ask them like, yo, you want my spot or something? And they'll be like, no, but you can see it in their eyes, like they do want that spot. And I'm not talking about my club per se, because I have a pretty tight circle and I'm blessed by that. But I've seen a lot of bullshit, you know what I mean? And that political shit breaks clubs apart. People don't know how to play their position. Like, you have to really analyze yourself and be real with yourself. The people that are leaders, they need to be in that position. Just because you want to look cool and be in that position, if it doesn't fit you, it doesn't fit you. Everybody can't be the president. Everybody can't be the sergeant at arms. You got to work with what you're given, and you will always shine. If you're being yourself, you will shine. If you're trying to be somebody else or have somebody else's position, you will always slip up, and you'll never be what you think you are. You're always going to be that person that's like trying to step on people to get to the top. And the only way to really rise is to work hard. The instant gratification that I talk about is the major problem. It's the reason why people won't work their way up. They'll cut the corner. Oh, if I talk down on the president, you know, I get a little cool with somebody a little higher up, I talk down the president, I could put myself in position. But that's not brotherhood. That's not why we join these clubs. So we need to bring it back to the essence. Why can't brothers feel happy? Like my prez doc, I love bragging about him. I love telling people, yo, he's the dopest prez ever. Why are people so weak-minded that they can't big up a brother? Why can't you big up your brother? That's your brother. If you can't big up your brother, who you gonna big up? People are too consumed with hate. You gotta uplift your brothers. I want all my brothers to get money. I want all my brothers to shine. I don't want none of my brothers to look whack. Like, that's how you gotta think, and that's how we'll win. If we all click up like that, and I don't mean just in clubs either. I mean it in life in general. If we learn how to like function together, we don't gotta be best friends with everybody, but at least in your inner circle, you can't be hating on the people in your inner circle. You gotta wanna see them win. If you could do something to help them, do it. Don't be a sucker, especially if you're not doing nothing and you got, you know, people in your team that got aspirations. You know, do your little bit to help. Don't just be such a sucker that they're only your brother when it's time to ride, because that's not brotherhood. That's just a riding friend. You know what I mean? Like, and who really needs that? You don't need a club to just have a friend to ride with. And a lot of times, let's be real, there's lone wolves out here that click up and ride more. You know what I'm saying? And don't have the bullshit going on. So that's why a lot of lone wolves sometimes don't want to join clubs, because they experience this clicky shit. The clicky shit gotta end. The clicky shit is beta. That's not alpha shit. Ain't no real men on no clicky shit. The clicky shit, all it does is cause separation. You will never grow with cliques. You will never get to what you aspire with clicky type people around you. Keep the energy around you that you want to get to the position you want to be in. And stop lying to yourself. Stop trying to be something you're not. Just be you. And whoever fuck with you, they fuck with you. If they don't, fuck them. Let's make it cool to not be clicky. If you see people at, you know, you at an event and you see people are like in little cliques, yo, walk over and be like, yo, what up, man? Yo, y'all stuck against the wall? Like, what up, brother? Be the one to mix it up, because this ego shit, you know, we're all men, and men always want to be the king of the jungle. You know what I'm saying? That's the problem with us. We can't just say, you know what, I'm a king, he's a king, we all have our waves. You know what I mean? Everybody always wants to be number one, and everybody got to be shit under the shoes. We're never going to get where we want to get like that. If you're the type of person that you do this, start checking yourself. Maybe subconsciously you do it and you don't even realize it, but let's fix ourselves. Let's make ourselves better and stronger, because we don't have to just say, well, that's the way I am and leave it like that. We could fix this shit and make it where we're so tight, when we see the next club, we could show them crazy love, because we're so consumed with positivity and great vibes that all these wars and all this shit ends. Because the vibe is so great with us, when we come around, it resonates with the other clubs. Like, we need to do that work ourselves. Thank you to everybody that's been supporting me and helping me rise the way I have. Thank you for supporting my clothing, my vision of Demons Row clothing. Follow the Souls the Ghost page. Thank you for tuning in to Demons Row TV, the holy grail of MC culture. Like, subscribe, and comment. And oh yeah, we ghosting, baby.